everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports.
With that, it's time to crown the champion of the NFC and to call the action. We send it to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, thank you. We are just off I-95 at the home of the Eagles, Lincoln Financial Field on the south side of Philadelphia. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Los Angeles Rams and the Philadelphia Eagles. Two teams that don't like each other much. One will go to Super Bowl 53. Underway in the 2019 NFC title game. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage. Stuff them in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play. Having leverage.
And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Aaron Donald in there to sack him for a loss of six.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And in contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Now Austin. And that is what you call a hit stick. Put down to the first. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the Rams will go here with a first and 10. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Again they run with Gurley. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
He'll look to throw. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. Losing 4 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw developing, ran to it, and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession. See if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how the defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've got to get a look at them, get a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. Second down following the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and 8. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Midfield, here's Wentz rolling to his right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 3-yard line.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
And it's had to pass block a lot on this drive for them to be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game.
And he fires one incomplete. He was looking for Keith Mumphrey that time. And it's third and short.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line. But it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. Wentz now on third and goal. Got a miss. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz from 3 yards out. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Oh, remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball to put it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone. Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first spin backwards, I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Looking to throw. On the right side, this is Austin with a catch. And he's brought down after a good gain. That one goes for 24.
To that, what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. We're only in the first quarter, so they didn't let a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is on the ground quickly after the catch. A lot of times they'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, a chance to make people miss an open field.
Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Robert Woods, the intended receiver that time. And it'll bring up third down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On third down, they'll run it with Gurley. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll bring up fourth down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
So look at this. Here's the field goal unit coming out, and he is going to need to bomb this one. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
To throw, it's Wentz. Steps away to his left. And that'll be incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Now a play fake. Wentz. Has it left side. And he's brought down. An Eagle first down there. Wentz to Ertz. And the names that end in TZ.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagle here to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense...
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Wentz finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and they're going to face a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
On play action, Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete.
I think that's a big-time play there, because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
And Sturgis able to knock it through, and the lead moves to 10-0. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. And the last go around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position. The ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence. Confident the kicker could make it. And even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold it.
They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game,
You're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down?
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
They'll drop to throw, and that's caught left side. It's Woods. They give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Got some breathing room. Look at the spin.
Balance.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been the running game for the most part that's powered him down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
I'm wondering, partner, if they might need to sub him out for a play or two because after that long run he just had on the previous play, he might not have all of his breath back.
Yeah, and they went right back to that well. Different result. On play action, they'll throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The intended receiver, Tavon Austin, at its third down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. They're going to look to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. That one. 1:59 to go in the first half. 1:59 to go in the first half. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights of this first half of play. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points. But they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
On the return, here comes Keith Mumphrey. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
Throwing on first is Wentz. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down.
Hurry, Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Play action. Now wins. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A nice gain of 21 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Throw left side complete. That's Foster. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up 1st and goal.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. Now before the 2nd down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. On 2nd down, here's Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. Some off. All in all, no gain earned.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
The offense on 3rd down, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and goal. Now Wentz. That's complete right around the 8. Good contain, no gain on the screen, and it'll bring up 4th down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Sturgis able to knock it through. So we've reached halftime. Who will represent the NFC in the Super Bowl? 2 more quarters to go. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Eagles are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Rams just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Eagles opening drive. Defense will get to the QB here. This one ends up as a loss of 6. Midway through the first quarter, quick pass and catch by Ertz. And he caps off the 6-play drive with a score. As they get out to a 7-0 lead, Eagles with the ball late in the half. The pass will be completed into coverage, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 23-yard line. So that's all for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll get you back out to the field now for some more playoff action.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. And they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Johnny Hecker now on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. He's going to field this at the four. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part,
rush coming, and he's taken down. LaMarcus Joyner in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Here's Wentz to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that's going to lead to a third and 12. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And he will score. Touchdown, LA. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. And you know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. And he puts it through. They're within three. It's 13-10. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They'll be looking to make amends for the events of a moment for 6 points.
You absolutely have to protect the football. That's got to be priority number one, because margin for error is starting to slip away. Now it's down to a one-score game.
Wentz now on first down. Eluding the pressure. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Andre Branch for a loss of 11.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
They fake the give. Now Wentz. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
It's Wentz. Sacked back at the two. Robert Quinn in there to get him the sixth time they've sacked him tonight.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Here's Jacob Shum now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. Here's Austin. It's a 45-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. And he's going to get this one down to the 45. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. Running back, and that play went nowhere, losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That's gonna go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
I'm getting the sense that Fletcher Cox is making offensive linemen want to take the week off when they have to play against him.
It's a regular routine for him, isn't it?
It really is. That play there, that's him all day long. Good luck trying to block him and keep him from disrupting your offense.
And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down. The Rams on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This time it's 3rd and 3. Now back to throw. And is it? And eventually taken down. But how about that athletic spin move we saw? Gives him the first down yardage. 12 yards that time. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs. Hitting on all 3 of those passes. And the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9.
But you know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to make it 4th down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job of limiting that and keeping them from a 1st down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that's going to tie us at 13. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
And they will not get a chance to reach one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle. So now, is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of 1st downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... And got his man, complete! And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line.
We just saw him hit a big play there on a deep post. And most of the time, the post isn't available because usually you have defenders in the middle of the field. But if you throw enough curls and crossing routes and underneath routes, I know from experience, they get tired of watching those balls get caught. They start to creep up a little bit, and that's when you can hit them big over the top.
And a give this time to the tailback. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3. One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. 13 all our score as we start quarter number 4. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On second down, they'll try and run the counter. He chucks him aside.
Dumped him.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
That is caught inside the 5. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Working from the gun, Wentz. That's caught at the 3. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Zach Ertz, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Eagles have taken the lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. That time, a 6-play drive. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Right now, Charles, this is the drive of the season. You're on the road here in the playoffs. It's put up or shut up. They need points.
This is where you have to come together as a team. As you just noted, on the road. So that means they've carried that mentality with them throughout. Hey, we've got to go out there. We've got to rely on ourselves, right? Focus, yet still find the fun in it.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Brandon Gray. Of 5. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Wide open is Watkins. He's got him. And he's brought down after a good gain. 23 yards on the play.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can hit and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
All right, here we go. Blue landed. Blue landed.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on fourth down, sometimes you're actually just praying, and on that play, the prayer was answered.
And now a first down following that long gain. He'll look to throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the eight. Timmy Jernigan getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of four.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
This will be caught at about the five. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. They'll look to throw. Yeah, he's got it. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. A great effort there. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Getting your back involved, what's the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. This one taken just inside the 10. And a good 30 to the 33-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And at the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it second and short. Time for a break. Back with more in the NFC Championship game after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
Back to throw, Wentz. Over the middle, complete. It's Foster. And he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
And they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll go down at the 28. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now Wentz. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Foster. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, no, he lost the football. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Wow, so they were already in field goal range. Now this and a completely new story to tell.
And frankly, what they're going to say when they review this game and go over it, they're going to tell the offense, he had one job. All right, you knew what you had to get done. You knew where we wanted to kick the field goal from. You know our range. Just take care of the football, and we win the game.
Let's go! Blue liner! Blue liner!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Out left, he's got it to Everett. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. And as the fourth quarter winds down here, we're all even.
And no one wants this game to extend. They want to go ahead and win it right now.
Let's go! Green 39! Green!
Back to throw. And he will find his man on the outside. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. That goes for a gain of 31. First down now, but the clock continues to move. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Brandon Graham. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Throw here. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And a nice little quick spin move before he's dropped. And a pretty good gain. Well, that sets him up for third down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He finds his man. It's Austin. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 12 yards there as they move the chains. They'll set up to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. 11 more on that one and another first down. Four quarters not enough. We're all even and overtime we go.
How much fun is this for everyone who's watching the game? How much fun is it for us to see this one get an extra period to get settled?
Overtime in a playoff game, awesome setup. Rules the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams kick field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In a regular season, only one period is played. We could call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a winner.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. You know, Charles, just thinking about it, plenty of recent conference championship games have needed OT to decide who goes to the Super Bowl.
And we can go back a little ways, can't we? Go back 2012. Giants in San Francisco. That was an overtime game. The Giants ended up going on to the Super Bowl. How about the Lambeau? And beat the magic of that stadium in that freezing, bitterly cold game and got it done there.
Yeah, it was 2008. It was absolutely freezing, and they went on to beat the Patriots in the Super Bowl that year. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First throw of overtime for Wentz. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Burton. And able before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. And he's got some space here. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Throwing now is Wentz. Forced out to his left. Throw left side complete. It's Gibson. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he's flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Well, partner, recent conference championship games that have been needed to decide who goes to the Super Bowl, what do you got?
Well, if we go back to 2015, how about Green Bay at Seattle? And it looks like Green Bay's got this thing. With Russell Wilson to Jermaine Kearse, that gets it done. And then go back to 2010. We think Brett Favre with the Vikings has the destiny. But they're in New Orleans. It's the Saints. And they get it done. And in overtime, go on to the Super Bowl. And they won that one. They beat the Colts, correct?
Yep. A couple of the more memorable ones for sure. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. Here comes a big one now in overtime. This is third and inches. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the eight. Just a yard, but that's all they needed, and by goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Gonna take it in, touchdown!
They're gonna win it!
And let the celebration begin! In an overtime thriller, they're off to the Super Bowl! And for all these guys, whether you're a rookie, a 10-year veteran, there's no feeling like this NFC champs.
And you feel like family. Anytime do you feel more like family than when you're sharing the joy of being the NFC champs? And now everyone gets to say they're going to the Super Bowl.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.